Good morning. It is time to demonstrate the directions of tangential velocity and tangential acceleration.
Flippin' physics.
Let's start by looking at 3 mints on a turntable of a record player. When we plug in the record player, it takes slightly less than 1 second to uniformly speed up to its constant angular velocity of 33 revolutions per minute. And then, when we unplug the turntable, it takes slightly more than 2 seconds to uniformly slow down to a stop. Let's define part one as when the turntable is uniformly speeding up. Part two is when the turntable is moving at a constant angular velocity. And part three is when the turntable is uniformly slowing down. Billy, please describe what you see when we add the tangential velocity vectors to the picture.
Okay, during part one, the tangential velocities of the mints look like they are increasing in magnitude. During part two, the tangential velocities of the mints are constant in magnitude. And during part three, the tangential velocities of the mints seem to be decreasing in magnitude. This must be because the tangential velocity equals radius times angular velocity, and in part one, the angular velocity is increasing. During part two, the angular velocity is constant, and during part three, the angular velocity is decreasing. And the tangential velocities are directly proportional to the radii. In other words, the mints which have a larger path radius have a larger tangential velocity.
Very nice, Billy. Now let's remove the tangential velocities and add tangential acceleration vectors. Bo, please describe what you see when you look at the tangential acceleration vectors.
Well, during part one, each mint has a tangential acceleration with a constant magnitude. During part two, the tangential accelerations are all zero. And during part three, each mint has a tangential acceleration which has a constant magnitude and is an opposite in direction to what it was in part one. And their magnitudes are smaller. This is because tangential acceleration equals radius times angular acceleration. And during parts one and three, the angular accelerations are opposite in direction. And during part three, the angular acceleration is less than what it is in part one. And during part two, the angular acceleration of the turntable is zero. Oh, and just like the tangential velocities, the tangential accelerations are directly proportional to the radius of the path, which means the larger the radius of the path of the mint, the larger the magnitude of the mint's tangential acceleration.
Well done, Bo. Now let's put all three parts on the screen at the same time with the vectors for tangential velocity and tangential acceleration simultaneously. And Bobby, could you please summarize what we see?
Sure. Looking at part one, the angular velocity is increasing, which means the tangential velocities are increasing in magnitude. There is a constant angular acceleration, so the tangential accelerations have a constant magnitude. Looking at part two, the angular velocity is constant, which means the tangential velocities have a constant magnitude. The angular acceleration is zero, therefore there is zero tangential acceleration. Looking at part three, the angular velocity is decreasing, which means the magnitudes of the tangential velocities are decreasing. The angular acceleration is constant and opposite the direction in part one, therefore the magnitudes of the tangential accelerations are constant and opposite the directions they were in part one.
Absolutely, Bobby. So notice, just like we talked about before with a bicycle, when an object is speeding up, the velocity and acceleration are in the same direction, and when an object is slowing down, the velocity and acceleration are in opposite directions. Now let's go back to just one turntable. Please be aware that Angular displacement, angular velocity, and angular acceleration refer to the whole object, whereas arc length, tangential velocity, and tangential acceleration refer to specific parts of or locations on an object, which is why we can describe the angular velocity of the whole turntable. However, when we refer to tangential velocity, we have to refer to the tangential velocity of a specific point on the object. For example, we cannot say the tangential velocity of the whole turntable equals any specific value, because the whole turntable does not have a specific tangential velocity. Only specific radii on the turntable have specific tangential velocities.
That makes sense. Sure. Okay, thanks.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.